Welcome back, famed theoretical physicist Michio Kaku, releasing a new book, The God Equation, which explains how physicists are searching for the one formula that can unlock some of the deepest mysteries of science. We're talking about it now with Michio Kaku himself. Michio, congratulations on this book. Tell us, what are some of the most important things you want readers to understand?
Well, the holy grail of physics is to find an equation, the God equation, an equation perhaps no more than 1 inch long that will allow us to, quote, read the mind of God. Now, I first heard about this when I was 8 years old. A great scientist had just died, and they put a picture of his desk on the evening news. And the caption said, "The greatest scientist of our time could not finish this book." Well, I was fascinated. I had to know, who is this man? I went to the library and found out this man was Albert Einstein. And that book was The God Equation. He couldn't finish it. It would unite all the laws of chemistry, biology, astronomy, all of it into an equation perhaps no more than 1 inch long, like E equals MC squared. That equation is half an inch long, but it unifies matter with energy. We want another equation which unifies the entire universe into an equation 1 inch long.
Yeah, it's great. These questions about space also come up. I was talking with the former director of national intelligence, John Ratcliffe, about UFO sightings. Listen to what he said. It's fascinating.
When we talk about sightings, we're talking about objects that have been seen by Navy or Air Force pilots or have been picked up by satellite imagery that, frankly, engage in actions that are difficult to explain, that movements that that are hard to replicate, that we don't have the technology for, or traveling at speeds that, you know, exceed the sound barrier without a sonic boom. So, in short, things that we are observing that are difficult to explain.
We're going to get a Pentagon report about these unidentified flying objects. You say that we will likely find intelligent life on another planet within this century. Tell us about that.
Yes, well, I'm a physicist. Not only do we work on the theory of everything, which, by the way, just hit the Amazon bestseller list, I'm proud to say, but we also think about, well, intelligent life in outer space. Now, you've heard the recent UFO sightings by the United States Navy. Objects moving between Mach 5 and Mach 20, 20 times the speed of sound, zigzagging in the atmosphere, and perhaps with no sonic boom. Now, some of these sightings, we think, can be explained by hypersonic drones. China, Russia, the Americans, they're all working on hypersonic drones which can maneuver in space and can attain Mach 20. So those attributes can be done in the laboratory, but without sonic booms, that's really hard to figure out. There could be an advanced technology at work there.